Meenakshi, how are you? What work all the time? I never get a chance to meet you alone. What is this to talk about something else or anything? You're not free only. What say you and I, we go for a cup of coffee, evening.
Ravi, I have a lot of work. I'm sorry.
Hey, come on, man. I'm trying to help you. I see whenever you have doubts, you go to that Shilpa only. Ask me, use me. I'll teach better than her. What say? Cup of coffee. We'll go. Come. Change of place.
No, not really. It's okay, Ravi. I'll work it out with Shilpa, and I'm not comfortable meeting outside. It's okay, please.
Oh, okay. Chill, 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 Meenakshi. Don't think something at all. All I'm asking for is a cup of coffee, yeah?
No, Ravi, if you want to discuss work, let's do it here. Okay? I don't want to come out. Is that fine?
Come on, yeah, not at workplace, too many people, too much of disturbance. We'll go someplace else. Outside is better, no? One harmless cup of coffee is all I'm asking. I'll pay. Come, we'll go.
No, thanks, Ravi.
Okay, fine, no problem. If not today, we'll go tomorrow, or we'll go day after tomorrow. I'll wait for you, no problem. Okay?
I said no, Ravi, no. You understand that? I said no, okay? Yeah, no. Yeah, I'm planning
Hi,
to
Sadhna. Yeah.
put my papers here. I'm planning to quit.
Why are you doing that? Arey, I thought we had a very good job, yeah. You're doing so well in your job. Plus, your team leader, such a great person. Why are you quitting?
Yeah, actually, it's not the problem with the job. Or the team. I'm not comfortable working with my team leader, Puneet.
What are you saying? Really? But I've heard such great things about Puneet, yeah. Puneet is supposed to be so knowledgeable and he teaches his subordinates also very well, yeah. He's a very nice, jovial guy. Why do you have a problem with Puneet?
First, even I had the same opinion. He's so such a jolly kind of person, always laughing, very helpful. But then suddenly I caught him staring at me a couple of times. I thought I was overreacting and I just brushed it off. Then a couple of times I noticed that he's walking up and down behind me when I'm working. And suddenly he'll be right next to me, his face, close to mine, just above my shoulder. He'll touch me in the pretext of using the mouse. Okay, and
God.
these things make me really uncomfortable, you know.
Yeah,
You won't
most definitely.
believe. One day, he just started passing comments. Yeah, he says you are looking hot. The design on the front of your clothes, you're looking so delicious. I
What are
just,
you saying? Really?
yeah,
Oh my God, that's
you won't
terrible.
believe. Yeah. You won't believe one day what happened. I just came out of the washroom and he came straight towards me and blocked my path. He just looked at me and said that, "Hi, sexy, you're looking so delicious. Can I eat you up?"
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my God, that's unbelievable. Why didn't you ever tell me something like this? You should have told me this earlier, no?
I felt really embarrassed and ashamed. He's such a senior person and everybody in the team loves him. They respect him a lot. So I thought like nobody would believe me.
I believe you. I trust you. I know that you might be telling the truth. I'm sure you're telling the truth. What are you going to do about it? Do you think he's done this to somebody else earlier, also in the team?
I don't know. I have no idea. They all talk in the local language and I don't understand. Sometimes they are laughing and they are talking. I don't know exactly what's happening between them. So initially I thought maybe I'm overreacting or maybe I'm the one responsible. The way I dress or the way I talk or the way I behave, probably it's because of that. And he's like very senior and he has been working here for so long and I just joined recently. So I thought it's better that I resign and I look for a job elsewhere. That's what will work, I guess.
Really sad to hear that, Sadhna.